Okay, ladies and gentlemen of algebra, you're looking at Unit 7, Notes 4, talking a little bit about probability. Some of you guys might have seen probability before, maybe even remember one or two things, but it's good to go over the details and remember what probability is, and more importantly, what probability is not. Probability just measures how likely something is going to happen. Probabilities are given a value between 0 and 1. 0 means there's absolutely no possible way that it's going to happen. One means that it is inevitable. There's nothing you can do to stop it. It is absolutely going to happen. The higher the degree of probability, the more likely the event is going to happen. The closer it gets to one, the more likely it's going to happen. This notation, which you will see quite a bit, literally means the probability of event A. So like the probability of rolling a dice and getting a 6, or the probability of rolling two dice and getting a sum of 12, things like that. Probabilities are calculated like this. This is the fraction you use. Number of things you want to have happen over everything that could happen. So a number of successes over total possible outcomes. So probability with dice. So if you're rolling a one die, or a number cube as it were. So probability of rolling a one. There's only one one, so that's one. Number of outcomes is 6, so that's going to be 1 6. Rolling a 2 or a 3 is going to be 2, 6, or 2, because you can have 2 or 3. So out of 6, so it's going to be 2, 6 out of 1 third. Please notice I'm leaving it as a fraction. Fractions make a lot more sense here. Decimals are just big and ugly in this case and don't work. Rolling an even number. Well, even numbers are going to be 2, 4, and 6. So that's 3 out of 6. So 3 out of 6 becomes 1 half. Rolling a number more than 2, so that's 3, 4, 5, and 6, so that's 4 possibilities out of 6, so 4 out of 6 shortens up to 2 thirds. Rolling a prime number, 2, 3, 5, those are your only prime numbers, so that's going to be 3 out of 6. 3 out of 6, as we saw above, is going to be 1 half. Now, decks of cards. Please take a second, look at the deck of cards. Pause it if you would. Just kind of give yourself an idea if you've never seen a deck of cards before, kind of how it works out. Every single suit, which is what these are, goes ace to king for a total of 13 cards. So 4 suits, 13 cards, clubs, diamonds, hearts, and spades. So there are 12 face cards, 3 per suit, 36 numbered cards, 9 per suit. All right, so it's 2 through 10, aces kind of play their own specific role. 26 black cards and 26 red cards. So taking a look at probabilities with cards. So 52 cards in a deck. So the probability of a spade, there are 13 spades. There's 52 total cards. So 13 out of 52, better known as 1/4. Probability of an ace, there's only 4 of those out of 52. Oops. So 4 out of 52 is going to be 1/13. The probability of a red card, if you look back, remember there's 26 red cards out of 52 total. So 26 out of 52 is going to be 1/2. So the jack of clubs, there's only one jack of clubs. So 1 out of 52 simplifies to 1 out of 52. Probability of a face card. Well, if you remember back, there's 12 face cards out of 52 cards, so 12 out of 52, which simplifies to 6 out of 26, 3 out of 13. So a complement probability means, complement means the opposite of probability, okay? So a complement means 1 minus the probability of some event happening, all right? So a complement means if the probability of rolling a 1 is 1/6, so complement says what's the probability of not rolling a 1? This is your complement right there. Please notice it is not saying something nice. That's not how it's spelled. Complement probability, mathematically, basically you take 1 minus the probability of that. So probability examples, you have a bag, 3 red marbles, 2 green marbles, 5 blue marbles. What's the probability of randomly grabbing a blue marble? So you have a bag, there's marbles in it. So you have 5 blue marbles. out of 10 total marbles. So the probability of you getting a blue is going to be 5 out of 10, or 1 half. So the complement would be, what's the probability of not getting a blue? Well, the probability of not getting a blue would again be 5 out of 10, or 1 half. So you decide you want to read Harry Potter, you go to your bookshelf and randomly pick one of them. What is the probability you do not choose the first book in the series? What's the probability you do not choose the first book in the series? For those that don't know, there are 7 books. All right. What's the probability you do not choose the first? Well, there's going to be 6 other books that are not the first out of 7 total, so it's just going to be 6 out of 7. All right, this might be a little hard to read. A bowl contains 2 green, 10 blue, and 8 red stones. 2 stones are chosen at random from a bowl. What's the probability that it is not green? All right, so you have 2 green, 10 blue, 8 red. So you have a total of 20 stones. So what's the probability that you take 2 and they're not green? So the probability that you take 2 of them and they're not green. So you're going to take 2, 10, and... So how many are not green? Well, 10 blue plus 8 red are not green. So the probability are going to be 18 out of 20 that they are not green. There's your probability. 18 out of 20 simplifies to 9 over 10. So you need to make a doctor's appointment next week. What's the probability that is on a weekday? All right, so it is on a weekday. Sorry. Well, 5 weekdays, 2 days on a weekend. So it's just going to be 5 out of 7. Let's back up here once. Something I didn't mention. 2 stones. So the probability of you not getting a green on the first one is going to be 9 out of 10. So now let's say you keep that one. You keep that not green stone. I don't care what color it is. It could be red. It could be blue. So that means there's 19 stones left. And there's going to be 17 stones that are not green. Okay, so the probability of not getting a green on the first is going to be 9 over 10. The probability of not getting a green on the second would be 17 out of 19. So we'll talk more about that, but just realize that there's 2 different events going on here. So 4 male, 6 female puppies at a breeder, what's the probability you will get a female puppy? Well, it's pretty straightforward. There's 6 female puppies. There's only 10 total puppies. So 6 out of 10 simplifies to 3 out of 5. There's your probability. All right, a single card is chosen at random from a standard deck of 52 cards. What's the probability of choosing a card that is not a diamond? Well, if it's not a diamond, here's another way to do it. So the probability of not a diamond is going to be just everything else that is a diamond. Well, one that might be easier is saying, what's 1 minus the probability of getting a diamond? Well, this is where a complement comes in. 1 minus the probability of a diamond. Well, the probability of a diamond, there's 13 diamonds. So 1 minus 13 out of 52 simplifies to 1/4. So the probability of getting a diamond is 1/4. So the probability of not getting a diamond is going to be 1 minus that. So the probability of not getting a diamond would be 3/4. Okay, that's all I got. Come talk to me with questions. Please double check answers, because this can get very confusing.